Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Dora. If you're visiting this channel for the first time, a big virtual hug to you. Welcome. Make sure you do not forget to subscribe so that you can join this wonderful family where we talk about how to groom and grow your natural hair in the most healthiest way possible. My subscribers, you know how we do it. As usual, a big, big, big virtual hug to you. I do not take your support for granted. Thank you for always coming back to watch my videos. In today's video, I am going to be answering a question that was asked by one of my subscribers. And the question was, how long did it take you to acquire the current length of hair that you have right now? So in order for us to do that, I always like, you know, to be doing something. So what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to retwist my hair as I explain to you, you know, five things that I have personally been doing, and I believe that if it has worked for me, it should be able to work for you too. So let's get down to business. So one of the things that has actually helped me to even groom healthy natural hair is I changed my mindset. Yes, if you believe that your hair is difficult to maintain, if you believe that your hair is not easy, if you don't like your hair, then definitely that is also going to influence your actions. Yeah. Change your mindset. When you change your mindset, you begin to appreciate what you have. You begin to love your hair. And once you love your hair, your actions will begin to show in how you take care of this beautiful hair. Number two, what did I do? In order for me to retain length or to have hair this long, is I took the time to educate myself. I took the time to get knowledge, to acquire knowledge about how to take care of this type of hair. And I believe that knowledge is power, but if you cannot apply knowledge, then that knowledge is useless. So this is what I basically do. As you can see, I don't engage in any type of tight hairstyles. No, I don't. My twists are usually loose, and basically that's how I wear my hair most of the time. So again, like I said, knowledge is powerful, because when you have the knowledge about of how to take care of this hair, it means you understand basic things. Like, for example, you need to deep condition your hair, you need to moisturize your hair, and you also need to, and you will get to know about those hair care practices that are very detrimental to hair growth. One of them is excessive heat. If you use a lot of heat on your hair, then you know that you're actually destroying your hair cuticles. The other one is, of course, the use of chemicals, chemical relaxers, all these things we use to bleach our hair. All these things look beautiful, but at the end of it all, they are detrimental to the health of our hair. My number three tip is techniques and skills. Okay, now if you want to excel in taking care of this type of hair, then you must also master the techniques and skills. And I'm already demonstrating to you one of the techniques is finger detangle your hair. When you finger detangle your hair, you understand your hair best, and you're able to feel any resistance that is on your hair strands. And when you do that, you can actually, you know, nicely get it out either than when you use a combo brush, because that will make you rip your hair. You see, I don't get, when you use your finger, minimal hair comes out, but also that is normal shedding. So the techniques are very important, and of course for this type of hair, whenever you during wash days, make sure you work with your hair in sections. If this video is making sense to you until now, please give me a thumbs up. Do not forget to subscribe, and of course share with someone out there who is looking for this kind of knowledge, this kind of content. Remember, sharing is caring. You share with someone, you help them to take charge of their natural hair. So skills, so important. How do you detangle your hair? How do you wash it? Or how do you, so whenever I shampoo my hair, I make sure I do my hair in sections. And you can see this is a skill, yeah? To finger detangle is a skill. You see, these are the tips. So I make sure, you see now, look at the ends, you see? If you're not careful, because of this, you will actually pull it. So you need to know the technique of separating this. Otherwise, you cannot retain length if you keep, breaking the tips of your hair. My tip number four is, use the right oils. Yeah, use the right oils. And I mean, there's so much oils, hair care oils out there, but you need to understand that different hair types can also respond different. They can respond differently to different oils. So for this type of hair, what this hair actually loves, it loves heavy butters. Yeah, what do I mean by heavy butters? You can actually do shea butter. Again, I have videos on how I make my own homemade shea butter. And of course, one of the things that I learned to do is I enhance my shea butter with herbs. So this is, this is how my shea butter looks like. And really, you can see that, it is, you see, it's just so rich. Yeah, so rich. So if you want to learn how to do that, there is a link up above. Please make sure you watch it, and also don't forget to share. So you can see, this is what I do. And do not leave your hair in protective hairstyles for a long time, because this type of hair, the more you leave them together, held up together, the more they actually, intertwine around each other. So the best way to manage them is, frequently separate them and finger detangle them, so that you're able to have a healthy hair. And also, when you do that, you actually spend less time trying to trying to remove the single strand knots. Tip number five is embrace your setbacks. Yeah, setbacks are the things that happen to us, especially when we are learning a new skill. When it comes to this type of hair, there's so much information out there. Before the natural hair movement started on YouTube, the whole thing about managing this beautiful hair was a mystery. So what that also means is that, you keep trying, you try to understand this. It doesn't work sometimes. Along the way, you're going to experience setbacks. So these setbacks should actually help you to understand your hair. And I don't think there is anyone who will understand your hair better than you, because you understand your hair much, much, much better than any other person out there. And the moment you do that, it means that you will experiment with different things. So it's a learning process. Learn, fail, ditch that one out. Learn, try it, it works for you, keep it in your archives. And that is how it actually works. So what this means is that keep trying and just move with what you manage to get right. So the lesson is keep going. Keep going, because it's a journey. It's a journey, and the more you experiment with your hair, the more you learn. And also, you need to appreciate one thing, that not all hair is the same. Yeah, so you cannot look at somebody else's hair and assume that even yours has to be like that. So that is what I learned, and these are some of the things that I can confidently talk about to you, otherwise without all that. So I also had series of setbacks. You know, you try this, it doesn't work, but then I did not give up. Now I'm at a level where I understand my hair 100%. I know when my hair needs moisture. I know when my hair needs to be deep conditioned. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this video, and if this video has made sense to you, please do not forget to give me a thumbs up. Share this video, share with your loved ones, with your friends, because this is how you show care, and let's get this channel growing. The more you support me, the more we spread the knowledge of how best to take care of this beautiful hair that actually does not need a lot of attention in order for you to manage it. So thank you for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.